And like the medication, it's a medication, but it's a verbal medication. Like the physical medication, when we take it, we should not believe that this will cure us by itself. We take it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to take it. We take it because the Prophet, peace be upon him, told us to take it. And we believe that without the willing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing of this will work. Nothing of this, including this vaccine that people, they are talking about, that Faraj came, alhamdulillah. But don't think that by taking the vaccine, you will be completely protected if you are not associating this with the willing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We see the situation, you see it, that in the same household, you get sick. One of these people take medication, it works for him. And another person in same household takes the medication, does not work for him. Why? There is a lack of willing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sight. What is the evidence behind having ruqyah in Islam? We have it from Quran, we have it from the practice of the sunnah of the Prophet, peace be upon him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ مَوْعِظَةٌ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَشِفَاءٌ لِّمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. Most of the scholars talked about that this shifa for sudur means guidance. Hidayah, guidance. And some of the scholars said, this is not only a guidance for your heart, but it's a guidance for your heart, also a guidance for your body. Whatever is needed for your body, you can have it by reciting Quran. For what you need for your hand, what you need for your vision, what you need for your ears, you will find it in the Quran. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Isra, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. Min from means from the type of the Quran, not from certain verses. From the type of the Quran, from this book. بالعربي نقول من هنا للجنس وليست للتبعيد. ما وننزل من القرآن ما هو شفاء ورحمة للمؤمنين. And also in Surah Fussilat, he said, قل هو للذين, means the Quran, قل هو للذين آمنوا هدى وشفاء. The scholar, they said, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the physical شفاء. Because if he meant just only guidance, he mentioned word هدى. قل هو للذين آمنوا هدى. Then said وشفاء. If you make a conjunction between two words, عطف, the first one should be different from the second one should be different from the first one. You cannot just join two words and they are same meaning. فهدن for your heart, شفاء for your body. Then also from the hadith of Imam Muslim from Auf ibn Malik al-Ashja'i, that he said, we used to make a ruqyah in Jahiliyyah. But at the ignorance time, they used to make a ruqyah. By Lat, by Al-Uzza, by Hubal, by Manat, anything. And they came to the Prophet, peace be upon him, and said, what do you think about the concept of ruqyah? The Prophet, peace be upon him, he said, nothing wrong with the ruqyah, but show me what you are doing first. Because they were just close to the time of ignorance time. He said, let me hear what you are going to say first. Then I approve it. I approve it if it's right. And there is nothing wrong with the ruqyah as far as does not associate shirk. Does not contain shirk association with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This hadith of Imam Muslim. The Prophet, peace be upon him, alayhi salatu wassalam, himself did the ruqyah. Hadith sahih of Imam Muslim reported by Sayyidah Aisha. She said the Prophet, peace be upon him, when he complains about anything, any pain in his body, he used to recite al-mu'awwidhat, qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq, and qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas, and he blows the air like that. This what the Prophet, peace be upon him, does in this occasions. And also the Prophet, peace be upon him, was treated with ruqyah. And also the hadith of Sayyidah Aisha, she said, Jibreel came to the Prophet, peace be upon him, and he made a ruqyah for him. But Jibreel made it via dua. Via dua. Through the calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, Bismillah yubrik, wa min kulli da'in yashfik. By the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to relieve you from this. By the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to cure you from all of the illness. Bismillah to protect you from min sharri hasidin idha hasad. From the one who's making envy against you or evil eye. Wa sharri kulli dhi ayn. This is the ruqya of Jibreel. We memorize it. And also we say it in several occasions if we are in need for it. And also the hadith that the Prophet, peace be upon him, did it for the others. Not only recommended them or Jibreel did it for him, he did it for the other companions. For hadith of Sayyidah Aisha also, she said, كَانَ إِذَا اشْتَكَى مِنَّا أَحَدٌ. When someone complains about sickness or disease, the Prophet, peace be upon him, used his honorable white hand to wipe off this part, and he says this dua. أذهب الباس رب الناس واشف أنت الشافي لا شفاء إلا شفاءك شفاء لا يغادر سقما. And this is also a type of ruqya that the Prophet, peace be upon him, did for his companions. The Prophet, peace be upon him, the hadith of Salama, that he came to his house, the house of Salama, one day, and he saw a girl, young girl, with has some yellowness. In Arabic, you say sufra, sufra, yellowness in her face. When you have this sufra, this means you are sick. You are not feeling well. And this is also evidence that they were not covering their faces. According to some people, they are promoting that every woman should cover. This hadith clear cut that she was not covering her face. The Prophet, peace be upon him, saw the sign of sickness in her face. Then the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, make a ruqya for her, because this she was a subject for an evil eye. She was subject for an evil eye. استرقوا لها فإن بها النظر.